Okay, so this is the paper. We'll do the first question first. First question looks like this. All right, you have, hey, sit down please. All right, so this one, pipe in parallel series. Pipe in parallel, one side got pump. Shown above, diluted gasoline 20. So the pump is wide open and not running with a loss coefficient of 1.5. Assuming the pressure drop is the same both legs. Right? Oh, yeah. Show that HL1 plus HL2 plus H pump. This H pump here is misleading. Alright, this H is not H pump. But this is H loss due to the pump. See? Pump not running. Why open not running? The loss coefficient. So, pump is not running, so actually. Okay? So, if this is a. I'll swipe this one. No, I need to download it first. Accessories. Okay. So this is point one, this is point two. Okay? So if you apply the energy equation between point one and point two, you get P1 over rho g plus V1 squared over 2g plus H1 plus H pump is equal to P2 on rho g plus V2 squared on 2g plus H2 plus head loss plus head turbine. Is that okay? So with this one, we can rewrite this for two branch one. Alright, well, for one, the pump is not really operating as a pump, so this one is actually zero. There's no turbine also. Okay, so for branch one, this is exactly the same, equals this is exactly the same, plus head loss is F1, L1 on D1, plus VA. Any other minor losses? No. Head loss in pipe one. Okay, now. Head loss in pipe one, which this one is equal to normally F1 L1 on D1 V1 squared over 2G. Is that okay? Alright. Why no pump? Because the pump is not working. Pump not on. It's just like another accessory. Pump's not spinning. Okay, so if you want to put H pump, you can put there, but the H pump is actually zero. Alright, by the way, this is through branch one. But branch one, there's no pump actually. Okay, branch two. This one's the same, equals this one's the same, plus head loss on branch two. Head loss of branch two is equal to F2. L2 on D2 plus V2 squared on 2GA. Hang on. Plus KL V2 squared on 2G. Is that okay? Alright. Pump not on. So that's why no pump. Okay, so if you subtract the 2, alright, you subtract the two equations, this one will disappear, this one disappear, you'll get this one equal to this one. Head loss 1 is equal to head loss 2 plus head loss pump minor comma pump. Is that okay? That's what you wanted. The question wanted you to show. Alright? So I subtracted the 2. Alright? I had that one minus this one equal to 0. This one. Alright? If I subtracted the 2, you'll get this one minus this one equals to 0. So this one equals to this one. Is that okay? Alright? Okay? So. The flow rate in each pipe and the overall pressure drop. Yep. This one is this term here. This term here is this term here. Alright, so the flow rate each pipe, the overall pressure drop. Okay. So we have alright. So here you end up with two equations are basically because you have to find flow rate. First equation is basically this one, F1 L1 over D1 plus V1 squared over 2G is equal to F2 L2 over D2 plus KL V2 squared over 2G. Is that okay? Alright. Two unknowns, V1 and V2. The other equation is Q total is equal to 0.04 meter cube per second is equal to A1 V1 plus A2 V2. Alright? Diameter given, so we can start putting in numbers. So two equations, two unknowns, you have to solve for both of them. Alright, any questions so far? Is that okay? So the total flow rate is the flow rate of is the sum of the flow rate from each branch. Okay, you must add up to 0.04. Alright. This is mass conservation. Okay. So pi 0.075 times 10 times 100 cm, correct. Pi d squared over 4 times V1 plus pi 0.025 squared over 4 V2 equals to 0. Okay. 0.04. All right. So I think you get like 9 V1 plus V2 is equal to 0.04 times 4 divided by pi 0.025. Is that correct? Alright. I divide everything by 0.0 by 4. I divide everything by 5.025 by 4 in this one. Here you get 3 squared. Okay? Is that okay? Hey, sorry, there's a square here. Let's stop loss. Alright, this is actually 3 squared. Alright, so what is this? Huh? 81.49. Okay? So that's equation 1. Equation 2, this one. Bit of a problem, huh? Okay. F1 and F2 don't know. They say guess 0.025. So what you're expected to do is guess 0.025, work out V1 and V2, alright, and based on V1 and V2, calculate the Reynolds number, look up the F, and then use that one, alright. So guess, F1 equals to F2 equals to 0.025. Alright, so guess 0.025 times L1 is what? L1 is 60, B1 is 0.075, B1 squared is tono, B1 squared over 2 times 9.81. Alright, actually this one can cancel out. Okay, equals F2 0.025, L2 is 55, D2 is 0.025, plus 1.5, minor loss, V2 squared. Alright, so you get something V1 squared equals something V2 squared. Alright, put down space here. What's the number here and here? Huh? V20 V1 squared? This one? 20, yeah. Fifty-six point five. Okay, so this is equation 2. So if you put that 2 together, 9V1 plus V2 is equal to 81.49. How to put together? V1 is equal to 56.5 over 20 square root V2. Correct. So you put this one in there, you get 9 square root 56.5 over 20 V1 V2 plus V2 equals 81.49. What is V2? And therefore, what is V1? Did I make any mistakes? Okay, after you've done that, the next step will be calculate the Reynolds number, I guess. RE of 1 is equal to rho V1 D1 over mu. RE of 2 is rho V2 D2 over mu. Equals what? Equals what? I think in this case, using gasoline. Are we using gasoline? Yes. So rho is 680, mu is 2.92 by 10 to the minus 4. Oh, roughness is 0.15 mm. So in this case, E over D, D1 is 0.15 mm over 75 mm. E over D2 is 225 mm. Over 0.15 mm over 25 mm. You get what V1 and V2 is? V1 is 5.08. V2? 8.49. Alright. What's the Reynolds number and the relative roughness? Let me calculate that one. Oh, it's the other way around. This is V2 and this is V1. Is that right? Huh? Correct. V2, V1. Yeah, I would appear that V1 would be bigger than V2. What's the Reynolds number? From vessel water connected to the vessel below, the narrow water contains two fluids. So, okay, provide a figure and the letter G for gravity and giving it so for the question below. Yeah? One point 48 times 10 to the 6. Second one. Huh? 2.94 times 10 to the 3. 5. The relative roughness? 0.00. This one is 2. This one? 006. ¿Se oye? Okay. Let's look up the F then. All agreeable, right? Alright, so look at F, got Moody chart. Yeah? Actually, I didn't photostat page 9 because page 9 is just a Moody chart. Alright. Okay, so Moody chart is here. Okay. What's the first Reynolds number? 1.5 million. About here, huh? What's the relative roughness? 002. Okay, so there. O 2 3. Alright, so the guess was pretty good here. Alright, 0.023. The second one? What's the Reynolds number? 2.9 times 10 to 5. About 3 lah. So 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4. So 3 is about here. What's the relative roughness? 006, is it? So this one should be 0.031. Three, two. How you get 3.2? Huh? Oh. Okay, sorry, only got 5 divisions. 0.032. Okay? So our guess of 0.05, not that bad. So what we are supposed to do now is take this new one, put it back into the equation, and calculate new flow rate. Alright? And if you want, well, if the question said iteration is enough, one iteration enough, but if you want, you can also double confirm that with this new new guess values, alright, that the, what do you call that? That with these new guess values, the friction coefficient that you find at the end will be the same. Let's do that. Okay, so this one is what? 0.023 and 0.032. So we put it back into here. So we put it back into here. Okay. But here, instead of 0.025, it becomes 0.023. Here, 0.025, here, 0.032. I guess these numbers will be different now. And this one. And then you solve again for B1 equals to what? B2 equals to what? Alright? If you're not happy, if you're not satisfied, you can go again with the V1. You can always calculate RE1 is what? RE2 is what? The relative roughness will be the same. Okay? E over D1 is 0.002. E over D2 is 0.006. Yeah, yes. You can always do that and find F1 and F2 again. Alright? And if approximately 0.023 and 0.032, then stop. Okay? Well, that's the processor. What's this number here? 18.4. And this number here? 71.9. After you solve what is V1 and V2?
Same solution technique that we did earlier, so I don't bother writing it here. You square root this one, then you can get V1 equal something, you put it there.
V1 is 8.57. V2? 4.34. What's the Reynolds number? 1.5 times 10 to the 6. This one? Not much different than the earlier one, huh? Just now was 1.48, now it came 1.5. Yeah, this one? 2.5 times 10 to the 5. This one was 2.9. Let's see whether it got any difference. I think it will be very small difference. Let's look it up again. 1.5 is going to be the same. .002, is it? That's fine. So that's same, 0.023. And the other one is what? 2.5 is here. 4.06. Same. Below. Same. .032. Okay, same.
Don't need to go anymore. Alright?
Okay, same. Stop. Okay. Then, final one, part B, ask you to find the pressure drop. Okay. Then we put it back into the Bernoulli equation. You can choose to do branch 1 or branch 2. I'll choose branch 1. P1 on rho g plus V1 squared on 2G plus H1 plus H pump, which don't have, equals to P2 on rho G plus V2 squared on 2G plus H2 plus head loss is F1 L1 on D1, V1 squared over 2G. Plus H turbine don't have. Okay? I assume H1 and H2 are the same. V1 and V2 are the same. Alright? This one and two is different from this branch one and branch two. Alright? This one and two here. This one and this one. This one and this two actually corresponds to this point here and this point here, right? After all this, so I assume that the I assume that the the velocity looks like same pipe and the same height. Okay? Because if not, you won't be able to do it. So I have to assume that one. And therefore, P1 minus P2 on rho G is equal to F1 L1 on D1 D1 squared on 2G. Alright, therefore, P1 minus P2 equals what? Alright, you can put in all the numbers. I forgot, they ask you flow rate, Q1 equals to V1 A1, Q2 equals to V2 A2. Alright, so actually, answer should be these three answers.
Not easy for 20 bucks.
Okay, what is the Q? Q1 and Q2? Or what's the pressure drop? Yeah, the velocity you found earlier. It should be the same, alright? You could put F1, L1, T1 over 1 squared over 2G, or you can put F2, L2, D2, E2 squared over 2G plus the final of the KL. No, this 2-1 is the starting and end of the branch. This one in here is the velocity in the pipe, branch 1 and branch 2. Right? So if you want to be confused, then you have to change the labeling. Maybe call this A and call this B. So it'll be PA minus PB, A minus PB. Alright? So where point A is here, point A is here, point B is here. Okay? Then branch 1, branch 2, A and B. Okay? Then you won't be so confused. So all this should be A, B, B, B. Yep. Yeah, can. Yeah, plus the minor loss. If you can replace it with F2 L2 over D2 plus KL V2 squared over 2G. You should get the same answer. Right?
That's what we showed at the start. It's supposed to be poor. You got answer? What's the answer?
Huh? 459 kPa. V1 and V2? Q1 and Q2? Anyone calculate that? 0.0? 379 meter cube per second. V2? 2. 2.13 times 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube per second. Alright?
Yeah, you can. If you want to take the hawking second branch, then you have to take all the information related to the second branch. Right? They all mix and match. Either take from the first branch or the second branch. Okay? They all say, oh, take left, you are whichever I like, leave whichever I like, and so on. Mix and match, so it doesn't work.
Is that okay? Alright, so if that's okay, you have a read and a question first. Okay, so I think all I say is this is question gravity 1.2. Alright, and this one is on water. Okay? Alright, so. Have you all read it? Okay? Alright, so let's see. Okay, write an equation for pressure at point 2 in terms of the, I guess, here and here same pressure, isn't it? And here same pressure. Alright, no? Okay, here and here same pressure, same height, same fluid connected, here and here same pressure. Okay, so I think first one, pressure at point 2 is equal to pressure at point 2 minus pressure at atmospheric is equal to rho A G. Rho A is 1.2 times 1000, I guess. Rho water, this one is 998, if you want to know. Rho A G times H3 minus H2. Is that alright? Okay, that's easy, 3 marks. 5 marks. Oh. Right, equation for H, the depth of water in the vessel in terms of variable given in the figure. Can I say it's an open vessel of water containing manually shown below? Okay, so here I think it's atmospheric also. So can I say between 2 and H, P2 minus P atmospheric is equal to rho water G H minus H2. Right?
H1 actually quite useless, I think. Just confuse you.
This height here is H minus H2.
Okay?
Well, then five marks. No, not yet, not finished yet. So, I think you need to equate the two. P2, okay. Rho A G H3 minus H2 is equal to rho water G H minus H2. So, this one, throw it over here. G can cancel off. H is equal to H2 plus rho A over rho water, H3 minus H2. I think that's the answer. That's for 5 marks. Or equals, I guess you could write it a bit more neater, rho A over rho W H3 plus H2 1 minus rho A over rho W. No, that's not good way to write. I think good way to write it is H minus H2 is equal to rho A over rho W H3 minus H2. Alright. So, this H2 is the same. Alright. This number is about 1.2, more or less. Okay. Alright, so it would appear that H3 would be less than H, isn't it? Is it clear to you? Alright, because of this relationship, alright, and this factor here is 1.2, alright, it will appear H should be larger than H3. Okay, ma'am.
So the difference between H and H2 is equal to approximately 1.2 times the difference between H3 and H2. Because this factor is more than 1, we expect H3 minus H2 to be less than H minus H2. Right? And since H2 is the same, alright? So we expect.
Again? We expect H minus H2 to be larger than H3 minus H2. And this one can cancel off. So you expect H to be larger than H3. Okay, let's justify your answer. So it's correct. Correct, and that's your justification.
If the vessel accelerates, is that okay? Alright. If the vessel accelerates with a constant acceleration to the left, will H3 increase, decrease, or stay the same? Justify your answer.
This one I also got tricked out. Lucky only 3 points. Okay, if he accelerates to the left, AX, we expect we expect the level of fluid to go like this, isn't it? From here to go maybe like here, isn't it? All right. So, except to the So we expect the level of fluid to go like this. All right. This will push this up. So effectively, H will increase. Alright? Anyway, H on this side of the manometer will increase. Okay? H on this side will decrease, but that doesn't matter. So you expect I will expect it to rise, I guess. Alright? It will rise. This one also will be fall and therefore. Okay? So expect H3 to increase. Alright? Again, this is your justification now. Alright? Justification. We expect H on left side on right side. Side of container to increase, therefore H3 also increases. Okay? Yeah, H bigger than H3. The row A is heavier, so it will tend to push down the H. Right? If you have heavier fluid in there, it will push down the that's what's actually happening. Row A is heavier than row water, so it will push down the whole H3 below the H. Okay. Is that okay? Any questions? Yeah. Okay, here, so I'll go down here. CM pipe connector reduced to 10 cm. Oil added 8%. Pump to the receiver. Okay. Alright, so you can sketch in your booklet, not exam paper, sketch the reducer showing all forces acting. So there's F external. Alright, there's the momentum flux going out, M dot V out, and there's momentum flux coming in. M dot V in. There's also pressure force. P. P. P2 V2. P2 A2. And there's pressure force P1 A1. Okay. Control volume will look something like this. Alright. So here the P is 0. Okay.
Inlet gauge pressure.
So they told you oil rho is 900, Q is 31.4 liters per second is equal to 0.0314 meter cube per second. That's 10,000. Correct. Right, rho Q, P1, gauge pressure is 40 kPa. Flow through the reducer such that viscous losses are negligible.
No, pressure, right? Pressure outside the pipe, 0. Right? So, except for the part where the control volume cuts across the inlet and outlet case, all other surfaces, pressure is 0.
Except for this phase here, P2A2, and this phase here, P1A1, the others are 0. Okay. So, in your booklet, sketch the reducer. What is the force? For 10 marks there. So, what is the force? First, sum of forces. In the X is equal to before we do that, let's find out the V1 and V2 is what is it? M dot is equal to rho Q is equal to, I don't know how many kilograms per second. Alright, rho and Q is there. Q is equal to V1 A1 equals to V2 A2. Alright, so Q 0.0314 is equal to V1 times 0.2 squared pi over 4 is equal to V2 pi 0.1 squared over 4. Alright, V1 equals, V2 equals. Okay, then we can put on this side. Forces here will be the pressure force, F pressure plus F external is equal to M dot out, V out minus M dot in, V in. Okay, F pressure in this case is P1 A1 minus P2A2 is equal to F plus F EXT equals to okay. What's the muscle rate? Huh? 28.26 kilogram per second. Okay. Ooh, that's high. V1 and V2? The one. V1 is 1 meter per second, is it? V2? 4 meter per second. Okay. So put in here. Eh? How to find P2? I think you need to use Bernoulli for that one. Huh? We need to find, so P2, so use Bernoulli, right? Which one? Okay. Bernoulli, P1 over rho g plus V1 squared over 2g plus H1 is equal to P2 over rho g plus V2 squared over 2g plus H2. Okay, we assume no losses are because here we don't know what the losses are. So, P2 equals, I guess you can put all in. Alright, P1 is 40 kPa. Find P2.
After you got P2, I think then only we got enough to do that
one. So here will be 40 kPa times area 1 pi 0.2 squared over 4 minus, I don't know what number it is, pi 0.1 squared over 4 plus FEXT is equal to m dot 28.26 times V out is V1. B2 4 minus 28.261. F external equals. What's the pressure at 0.2? What the KPA? 33.3 and external force? So 33,300. Alright. You got an answer? Negative 910 Newton.
Which is right. The external force should be pointing to the left. Alright? A nozzle, your whole clearly the whole nozzle. Right inside the nozzle.
Fluid on this one is you are asked for fluid on reducer. All right, you are asked for fluid on reducer, so that one is 910 newtons to the left, to the right. Okay, positive.
Switch the sign around.
Okay. See, in reality, let's bring back. Basically, you just need to look at this one. Copy. All right. Measured, so that one shouldn't change, isn't it? Alright, the pressure gauge says 40 kPa, that should be 40 kPa. Area 1, area 2 is still same, m dot is still same, so therefore the velocity is still same. Okay, not so all these are same, all the one I think. Okay, not so the in reality, if there's any viscous losses. It will only affect P2. Is that okay? Alright? No, as long as it drives at the same flow rate, alright? The liquid cannot disappear. Alright? As long as it drives at the same flow rate, you will still get the same velocity. Alright? So, in reality, P2 will actually. Okay? P2 actually reduce. Okay? So therefore the F external actually reduce, actually becomes more negative. Right? Because F external is already negative.
So it becomes more negative.
Right, so actually the magnitude increases. Okay, so
direction is the same, just the magnitude increases. Direction same.
Okay.
Yeah.
Huh? Same direction as what you found here, this one. Reducer and fluid is to the left, fluid on reducer to the right. L is 0.3.
Okay. So with this one, it's actually going into the page, but I just draw top view, not I can't draw into the page. Alright, so
I guess the top view looks something like this. I'll just define this as X and this as Y. I guess this is point 1 and this is point 2 and this is our control volume as usual. Is that alright?
Is that clear enough? Alright, it's just an elbow. Alright, comes in at 4, must leave at 4, just a 90 degree turn. Alright?
Just that they don't draw the picture for you. So the M dot must also be the same as earlier, 28.26. I think that's about it. Okay? So I guess P1 on rho G plus B1 squared on 2G plus H1 is equal to P2 on rho G plus B2 squared on 2G plus H2 plus head loss in this case is just KL B squared on 2G. Right? There's no major losses. Right? There's no pipe. So, from here, I think V1 and this one. P1 minus P2 on rho G is equal to change in pressure. KL is 0.3. Four squared on 2, 9.81. Right, rho is 900. Eh? So I think they want the change in pressure. P1 minus P2 is what? How many kPa? So I guess here is 33.3 kPa. Here is what's the pressure here? What's P1 minus P2? Sir? Huh? 31.09 kPa. What's the difference? 910. Huh? 8910 Pascal. Okay? Huh? Which one is 2160? Okay? I guess then after that is just your on the fluid in the elbow. F external. All right, in the right, fluid acting in the elbow, P1, A1, okay, sum of forces in the X equal to F pressure, P1, A1, plus no matter, I push it pointing. Plus F external in the X equals to M dot out V out minus M dot in V in. So P1 A1 is 33.3 K. A1 is pi 0.1 squared over 4. Yes. Plus F external. M dot, what's M dot? 28.26. What is V out? I guess that is in the X component, the V out is 0 minus V in here is 4. Is that okay? Alright. Then you can find F external X is what? For the Y, I think you end up with this one because it's pointing down, minus P2A2 plus F external is equal to M dot out V out minus V in. Okay, so in the Y, you get F external equals to P2A2 is what? 31.09, 31.09 K times pi 0.1 squared over 4 plus M dot out 28.26, V out is 4, V in is 0. Okay, it's all agreeable? Well, I drew it twice up. This is the diagram, it's just an elbow, X and Y. Right, the pressure and inlet velocity. What's the answer? What's the answer? Negative 374.2 newton. This one? Positive 357.2 newton. Okay, let me, I'll give you a few more minutes. The x component here is 0 and the y component here is 0, but it's actually the magnitude is still 4.4. Right?
Why the pressure point
don't
include the P2 inside?
The P2 also, the component is only in the y.
Oh, not
the x. P1 only in the x component, no y. Magnitude and direction. So x is this way. Three
357.2 347.2 plus 357.2. Okay.
Hey, magnitude and direction. Up to you, I can calculate. But I don't think.
I think for 8 marks, I wouldn't expect all that. If you get these two, enough for you.
Alright, can we proceed? Okay? In 3 to 5 sentences,
and with the aid of diagram, if necessary, explain why turbulent flow left might be separate and angular flow.
All right. Yeah, the one. Lamina. Boundary layer. Turbulent. Boundary layer. Alright? So okay. What to say, yeah? Turbulent boundary layer has more mixing and therefore faster moving fluid near wall. Is that okay? Alright, therefore need more reduction therefore need more reduction in velocity before flow reversal happens and therefore harder flow reversal is when separation flow reversal this is separation occurs when there is flow reversal. Okay, so flow reversal happens, therefore harder to separate. Okay,
does that make sense? So I'll read again. Turbulent boundary layer has more mixing and therefore faster moving through it near the wall. Alright? Need more reduction in velocity before flow reversal happens, therefore harder to separate. Separation occurs when there is flow reversal. Is that okay?
Now, next one.
Okay. This one. This one, this one.
Ask you why
is the center of pressure below the centroid?
Okay. Why?
Why? So why is because like this? Right? If this is your gate, this your let's start it from the surface, make it simple. Okay. This halfway is the centroid. Why not? So this is the centroid. If you think about it, if I put a pin at the centroid, will the gate spin or not?
If I put a pin here, the moments on this side and the moments on this side, same or not? Not the same. Okay, so the gate will spin.
If I put a pin at the center of pressure, CP, okay, which is normally below the centroid, okay, then
the at this point the moment on this side, moment due to the pressure or force of this side matches the one on that side. So that's where the center of pressure is. If you put a pin here, the gate will not spin. Okay, no spinning. Alright. How to put that in words?
What happened? Okay. What do you do? Explain why in 3 to 5 sentences. Alright. I think number one, pressure, magnitude, magnitude of pressure, larger. At close larger at regions close to bottom of gate. Okay, number two, at the centroid, at centroid from a moments due to pressure forces not balanced. All right, at center of pressure, all right, number three, at CP, moments which is usually below YC, Y centroid, at YCP, center of pressure, which is below YC, moments, balance. Because forces are greater on the lower sections. Okay. Is that okay? A, B, C.
Is that okay so far? Any questions? Alright, so I believe all talking away for the question. Yeah. This question is easy, huh? Alright? Using Bernoulli equation in 3 to 5 centers, how aerofoil generates heat.
So I guess normally you would draw the picture. Alright. Okay. So here, the path long. Here, the path short. So here, long path is a short path. So here, therefore, the velocity must go up. Here, the velocity will go down. Alright. What else? Therefore, the pressure will go down, and therefore, the pressure will go up. Right? Because Bernoulli, P on rho g plus v squared on 2g plus h equals constant. Alright, so one, if pressure go up, velocity go down, pressure go up, and so forth. Okay? So here, low pressure, get suction. Suction, pushing. Alright, P force. Okay, explain our aerofoil generates lift. Okay, so that's a picture in 3 to 5 sentences. Shape of aerofoil causes velocity on top to be faster than velocity below. And to therefore, V on P on top from Bernoulli equation, P on top, P on top reduces and P below increases. Therefore, generate lift. Okay? Thank you. Okay. So the last one, you are required to pump. You are required to pump water between two large tanks. Head rise of 10 meter. So head pump, 10 meter. Flow rate 30 liters per second. Alright. So let's see here. 30 is about here. Okay, and 10 is about 8, 9, 10, 11, 8, 10. 10 is about here lah. Okay. So which pump to choose, huh?
Obviously, the 7.25, 8 inch and 9 inch pump at 30 liters per second, the head rise is less than that. Is that okay? So, what I've drawn here, 30 liters per second and 10 meters. So, that's our operating point, our minimum. Alright? So, the 7 and a quarter inch, 8 inch and 9 inch pump cannot use. Is that okay now? At that flow rate, the head rise will not be 10 meters. And so if you use a 10-inch pump,
at Q equals to 30 liters Q 30 liters H equals to what? About what, huh? 12 about 13 meters. Alright, so that one can a bit extra head, never mind.
Alright, okay.
So must choose 10 inch pump. Okay, 10 inch or 11 inch also can, but 11 inch is a bit too overkill.
Alright. Is that okay?
Alright. And why? Okay? Because 10 inch pump. The why is because 10 inch pump can deliver more than 10 meters at 30 liters per second. Huh? 1180. Yeah, no, I think I'm correct. 1180. Okay. So
the pump, the manufacturer's data, all the pump are running at 1180 RPM. Okay? The loop are even. Don't touch my pump. Yes, at 1180 RPM, we follow the
okay. So the part, the next one I think is pump scaling. Alright. Which formula we need, I get the formula first. We need alright, this part here is trickier. If we if we scale the pump from just this operating point, alright,
if we scale the pump just based on this operating point, if we reduce the velocity, all three parameters will be reduced. The flow rate, alright, the heat rise,
and the power, alright.
So I repeat again, if you were to just take this operating point and scale it down to 1000 RPM, both the heat rise, the flow rate, and the power will reduce. Okay? So that may not be very good. Okay? So we need to actually scale down from not from
this point, because we need to scale down from a point slightly higher. Okay? So that by the time we scale it down, the flow rate is still 30 meters per second. Okay or not? Alright? So if you took this point, okay, you scale down maybe 30 meters, you scale down still maybe more than 10 meters, okay. But definitely the flow rate will be less than 30 meters per second. Okay? So let's see what... So for flow rate, okay, we Q2 is... So the initial one we don't know. Let's say Q1, alright, we don't know. Q2 after scaling down is still 30 liters per second. Alright, omega 1 is 1180, omega 2 is 1000. Alright, and as usual, we say CQ1 equals to CQ2. Therefore, Q1 over omega 1180 times D1 cube is equal to Q2, which is 30, 1000 D2 cube. This D1 and D2 are the same. Alright? So, Q1 is equal to 1180 over 1000. Times 30. Okay, now.
So that we effectively the original pump is operating at slightly higher flow rate. Alright? So that after scaling down, it's still 30 liters per second. Alright? Okay. So what is Q1?
Huh? 35.4. Okay? So our operating point 1 is actually here, 35 here, see. Alright? We're still using 10-inch pump. Alright.
So if it originally operates at 35 liters per second, 1180 RPM, after scaling up to 1000 RPM, it will operate at 30 liters per second. Okay. Alright. So at 1180 RPM, the heat rise is about 12 meters. Okay. So
this is point one. This is the original one. Okay? So original one, it operates here at 1180 RPM. It will pump 35.4 liters per second. Alright, after scaling to 1000 RPM, it will operate at 30 liters per second. Alright? So now that first one. Step two, we need to check the head. Alright? Okay, so head 1 is about 12 meters. Is that okay? About right, eh? Alright, omega 1 is 1180, omega 2 is 1000. What is H2? Okay, so GH over omega squared T squared equals to GH over omega squared T squared. Okay, this is 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2. Okay, you can find H2. What is it?
So we are scaling the speed from 1180 RPM to 1000 RPM.
Because if not, if you put here, if you put Q1 as 30, Q2 be less than 30. Alright. Okay? And then you say pump fail already. But in actual fact, maybe the pump will not fail. Alright? So, if the pump operated at 1180 RPM, at a slightly higher flow rate, it is able to, what do you call it? It is still able to supply 30 liters per second at the 1000 RPM. Alright? If not, you know your question is very short. I put here 30, here less than 30 fail, which is not the case. The pump can operate at higher flow rates at 1180 RPM. So that at 1000 RPM, it still operates at 30 liters per second. The head, I read off from the graph, 12 meters. So what's the head here? Huh? 10.1. Okay, still pass. Still more than 10. Okay, pump can be used at 1000 RPM. Alright? 1000 or 10,000? 1000. Okay? What's shaft power? 8.6. Alright? So 8.6 then cannot, yeah? Is it 8.6? 8.6. So, no, cannot operate. This is less than 10 meters. Pump cannot be run at 1000 RPM. Okay? So at 1000 RPM, if you were to deliver 30 liters per second, you would get only 8.6 meter head rise. So cannot. Okay. Okay. Then last one.
Minimum shaft power required to pump at 1180 RPM.
Alright, at 1180 RPM. So, cannot perform as required, no. Determine the minimum shaft power. Huh? Yeah. I don't know, you still ask to determine the minimum shaft power. Alright. At this point, minimum shaft power is about 7.5 horsepower. Alright. It's about 7.5 horsepower. Is that okay? Alright. You are here, and this is about the 7.5 horsepower line, so where this intersects here. Here will be less than 7.5, here will be more than 7.5. It's about 7.5. Alright. This is 7.5, 10, 15 horsepower. So where these lines intersect, your curve, that's...
And anywhere in between, you have to extrapolate. Is that okay? Alright. 1000 RPM,
I don't know, do you want to take this point or this point? Both doesn't work anyway. Alright, what's the power? Power over rho omega d cube d5. Cp equals the power over rho omega cube d5. Alright, I think omega 1 is 1000, omega 1180, omega 2 is 1000. Rho is the same, power P1 is 7.5 horsepower, P2 is question mark. Alright, you can calculate that now. Okay. Okay, what's that power? Huh? 4.56. Yeah, save a lot of power, but it doesn't work. So it's useless. All right. I guess we'll finish here. You guys want to do some more in the afternoon? Okay. So I guess we'll take a lunch break now. I'll get back about 1:30. Right. Stop.